everyone, it's Sam. So today is going to be more of an informative video. I just want to go over a few things based off questions that I've gotten from clients and just family, friends in general. A lot of people are expressing just concern that they have limited equipment and things like that at home. They're worried about losing some of the progress that they might have been making lately. So I just kind of wanted to show you a few different ways, really simple and straightforward, that you can kind of ramp up your workout, even if you have limited equipment and stuff like that at home. So all I have here in my apartment is just one kettlebell, some bands, and sliders. Sorry, I didn't know my dog was behind me. But so there's really simple ways that you can just change up the exercises to make it a little bit more challenging, even if you don't have a heavier weight and things like that. And a few different ways to do that is playing with the tempo of the exercise. So you're just gonna slow it down. And then you can also add in holds and stuff with the contractions. So just a couple seconds. You can add in pulses. Again, right near where the contraction is. And then the last way that you can do it is adding a half rep. So all of these things are really straightforward and basic. I'm gonna show you them through three different exercises. We're gonna do squats, lunges, and push-ups. But you can really take these principles and apply them to any workout that you're doing. If you have dumbbells and you wanted to, you know, like bicep curls or some shoulder work and things, you can definitely do all of these with any exercise that I'm gonna show you. I just like to focus on those three because they utilize a lot of muscles, so they're compound exercises. So essentially you get the most bang for your buck doing the exercises because you're gonna be recruiting a lot more muscles since they're more compound movements. So we are gonna get started with the squats first. So I'm not gonna demo with the weight or anything like that. I'm just gonna show you body weight, what you can do. And then feel free to add in a weight if you would like to. If body weight is a good starting place for you, that's great. You can add in a few different like dumbbells or kettlebells of different weights. Feel free to play around with the weight, see which one feels good for the level. But like I said, I'm just gonna show body weight and we're gonna start with squats. So I gotta go around my dog here. I didn't realize she was sleeping here. So for the squats, your feet are just gonna be about hip distance or so. And then, so we're gonna start off with the hold first because that's pretty much the most straightforward one. So a couple form cues, just make sure you're keeping your weight in your heels. You want your back to stay nice and flat. I'm gonna show you from the side just so you can see the range of motion. So whenever you're squatting down, you wanna make sure just till you're about parallel with the legs and then all the way up. So for the hold, what we're gonna do, we're just gonna hold it at the very bottom of the contraction. So for that, you're just gonna squat down. We're just gonna hold for one, two, three, and up. Start off with a couple seconds, 2 to 3 seconds. If that's not challenging enough, you can definitely lengthen that to about 5 seconds, really as long as you would like. It just really depends on what feels good for your level. So again, you're just gonna do basic squat, hold, two, three, four, five, and up. So just a nice solid hold there at the bottom of the squat. For the pulses, we're gonna go down just to about that same level. So again, just till your legs are about parallel, keeping the weight in the heels and the back flat. You're gonna go down. We're just gonna do one, two, three little pulses and up. So you wanna stay nice and low because you wanna keep tension in the muscles. So you don't wanna do like big pulses like this. So staying just nice and low, two, three, and up. And again, you can add in more or less pulses, see how that feels. Next one we're gonna do are the half reps. So this one, you're gonna combine a full rep, and then you're gonna come up halfway, and then go back down, and that's gonna be one rep. So one whole rep and a half rep equals one whole rep when you're doing these sets. So same format, feet just about hip distance or so. And then, so we are going to go all the way down, come just about halfway up, so a little bit higher than the pulses, then you're gonna go all the way back down and up. So that is one rep. So again, squat down as far as you can, just about halfway, all the way back down and up. And then, so our last one here, we're gonna play with the tempo. So we're gonna do a slow lowering phase, and then we're gonna take it up nice and slow as well. So with this one, usually, again, I start with about 3 seconds, see how that is. Again, you can make it longer, shorter, just anything that kind of feels good for your level. So again, same setup. We're gonna have the feet about hip distance, keeping the weight in the heels back flat as long as you can. So we're gonna go down, two, three, slight pause, up, two, three. We'll do five counts next just for demo purposes. So we're gonna go one, two, three, four, five, slight pause, up, two, three, four, five. So those are all of the four methods. You can also mix and match these if you would like. So that's up to you. So if one isn't challenging enough on its own, you can combine them. So I'm gonna show you one that's pretty common. So we're gonna do a hold and a pulse. So we're gonna go down, two, three, pulse, two, three, and up. So again, you can do the pulses first. You're gonna go down, two, three, and hold, two, three. It doesn't really matter which way you do one or the other. The goal is just to keep nice constant tension in the muscle the entire time. So if we wanna combine, say, tempo and a hold, we're gonna go down, two, three, hold, two, three, up, two, three. Try to always keep the counts even whenever you're combining the holds and the tempos. If you wanna get really crazy, we can combine the tempo with the holds and the pulses. So we'll go down, two, three, hold, two, three, pulse, two, three, up, two, three. So again, feel free to mix and match, see which feels good. For reps, usually I start people off anywhere from 8 to 12, especially if you're gonna add in a weight. Sometimes when you're adding in those little extra pulses, holds, or the half reps, sometimes you have to back it down to maybe even 8 reps if you usually do, say, like 10 to 12 or even 15. So start with less reps and then build up and see how that feels. So next we are going to do lunges. So you're gonna start with 1 foot forward. We are gonna do, again, the hold first. So your leg's gonna go back behind you, and then so for the hold, you're gonna start with the leg straight. So we're gonna go all the way down, as low as you can. Hold, two, three, and up. It's the same thing. So just down as far as you can. Hold, two, three, and up. So I'm gonna switch legs between demos just so the one is getting more tired than the other. And then, so we're gonna add in pulses. These are probably my least favorite with the lunges. I think they're really hard, which means they're probably really effective. So these ones, sometimes I don't even add in a weight, I just do body weight. And by the time you get to reps 10 to 12 and you do a couple sets of those, your legs are good to go. So we're gonna keep left foot forward this time, keep the weight in the heel, start with the leg straight. So we're gonna go down and then pulse, two, three, and up. So we're gonna do 5 here just for demo purposes so you get an idea of that. So again, back leg goes back. We're gonna go down, two, three, four, five, and up. For the lunges, usually I recommend doing all of the sets on one leg. So if you're gonna do 10 reps, do 10 reps on the right side and then do your 10 reps on the left side. For the next one, we are going to do the half rep. So again, I'm just switching legs. So I'm gonna have right foot forward this time, keeping the weight in the heel. So we're gonna go down all the way, just about halfway, a little bit higher than the pulses, all the way back down and up. So again, that's just one entire rep. So you're gonna go down, halfway, down, and up. And then last one, we are going to do the tempo. So we're just gonna start off with 3 seconds here. So same exact set, keeping the weight in the heel of that front leg. Start with the leg straight, we're gonna go down, two, three, very slight pause, up, two, three. We'll do 5 next. So down, two, three, four, five, pause, up, two, three, four, five. Nice and slow and controlled. So again, same thing with the squats. You can customize these by adding, you can combine these, adding 2 different methods or more. So we are going to do the hold and the pause again. Hold and the pulses, I can't talk today. So we're gonna keep one leg forward, weight in the heel. We're gonna go down, two, three, hold, two, three, and up. We'll do 5, nothing crazy. So down, two, three, four, five, hold, two, three, four, five, and last one we are gonna do, just a tempo with a hold. Again, try to make the counts even. We'll start off with five here. So we're gonna go down, two, three, four, five, hold, two, three, four, five, up, two, three, four, five. All right, so next we're going to move on to push-ups. So for these ones, I'm gonna demo just regular push-ups, so with arms straight, knees up off the floor. If you need to, you can take it down onto the knees. If you have an inclined surface, like a couch, a bed, or a chair, anything that'll really be stable and hold your weight, you can do them on an inclined surface if you would like.
All right, so we're gonna get started with the push-ups, and like I said, you can do them on your knees, down on the floor, or up on the inclined surface. I have my assistant with me again today. She's sleeping though. So we're gonna start. I'm gonna do a slight angle just so you can see my whole body here. So arms are gonna be just about shoulder width, and then you wanna make sure that your wrist is in line with your shoulder, so you don't want them too far out or too far down. So just right till they're about level with the chest. We are gonna start with the hold first. So keeping the core nice and tight, squeeze the glutes together. You're gonna go down, hold, two, three, and up. Next, we're gonna do pulses. So we're gonna do the same thing with the setup. Make sure the wrists are in line with the shoulders. We're gonna do just 2 to 3 pulses. Usually I have people do less for upper body just because upper body tends to be a little bit weaker. So we're gonna start with just 2 to 3 pulses. So we're gonna go down, 2, 3, and up. And then, sorry, I had to give my arms a break there. So next one we are gonna do is the half rep. Same exact setup, keep that core nice and tight. You're gonna go all the way down, halfway up, all the way back down, and up. Try to keep the elbows tucked in, you don't want them flaring out towards the sides too much. And then next one we're gonna do a tempo. So again, we're gonna do 3 seconds, but if you need to take it down into 2 seconds, just kind of see what level feels good, and feel free to take it down to the knees anytime you need to. Like I said, we're gonna do 3. So you're gonna go down, 2, 3, and up, 2, 3. Nice and slow. Down, 2, 3, up, 2, 3. So just doing a couple demos is enough of my upper body right now. But like I said, you can combine those as well if you'd like. Kind of the same setup that we did for the lunges and the squats. You can go down, do a hold, do some pulses. Do nice slow tempo. Usually for upper body, just because like I said, they tend to be a little bit weaker than lower body. Combining them can sometimes be too much right now. So just starting with these 4 basic methods can be a really good starting place to ramp up your push-ups and things like that. And then, so one last thing that I just wanted to touch on, because people are, you know, concerned about their fitness goals and things like that, because timelines are extremely uncertain right now. We don't know how long everything is going to go on for. That true muscle loss takes a lot longer than we would think. I know it kind of seems like, you know, being stuck inside a lot of the times that we feel like we're losing a lot, but really and truly, it's not as much as we might think, just because we're altered from our daily routines and workouts and stuff like that. And then the other thing to keep in mind, if you do lose muscle, it's not the end of the world. If you have been active, weight training and stuff like that before this happens, you know, like the saying, if you don't forget how to ride a bike, well, let's do the muscle memory. So as soon as you get back into it, that muscle is gonna come on your strength, your gains a lot faster than the first time around when you were first getting into this and lifting and things like that and saw those muscle improvements. That initial period takes a lot longer. So when you come back and you start lifting with the same weights that you were before, doing those exercises, that muscle is gonna remember and it's gonna come back a lot faster. So those are just a couple things to keep in mind, because I know everyone's going crazy trying to figure out how to work with their fitness goals at home. But just be patient with yourself, try out these tips and things like that, let us know how you feel about them, and hopefully you get to see more videos from us soon.